This is a job interview from hell. Your prize is working with me.
Some of Britain's most self-assured business talent, London.
As a salesperson, I rate myself as probably the best in Europe.
You know, someone came up to me and said, you're arrogant. I say, you're 100% right. I am arrogant. And what are you going to do about it? That's the way I am.
To me, business is simple. It's about making money, and making more money.
They came to fight for the chance to work for the capital's toughest taskmaster, Sir Alan Sugar.
Don't start telling me that you're just like me, because no one's like me. I'm unique.
Each week, Sir Alan set tasks designed to test every business skill.
Yeah, lovely, 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 like it.
That is the sign of a good salesperson.
Yes!
But as the going got tough, the teams fell apart.
We're looking like idiots.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
Do not speak to me like that. How dare you?
And someone always got the blame.
You haven't got a bloody clue. Not a bloody clue. You're fired. I hold you totally responsible. You're fired. No. No good. You're fired. Goodbye.
Tonight, why I fired them. The boss explains.
Right, who's next?
Please.
Silent, please.
You're fired. You're fired. You're fired. I wanted people from all walks of life, academics, people that were just streetwise, people that were already in business. We had barristers, we had an ex-army man, we had people with high corporate knowledge, people that do telesales, people that work in retail organisations, a really good group of people from a very broad spectrum of skills and education and walks of life.
Sir Alan will see you now.
I meet them for the first time in the boardroom. First time they see me also.
Well, nervous? Apprehensive? Good. You should be.
You must never ever form opinions of people by first impressions, because I've learned from bitter experience over the years that you form an opinion and that opinion is normally wrong. That's the beauty of the process. Of 12 weeks, because you get to know people, not just from first impressions.
Just minutes into that 12 weeks, the 16 candidates learned their first lesson. Never second guess Sir Alan Sugar.
You might think you're going to go off now and settle in. Well, you're not, because business starts now. I think they were sitting there in the boardroom thinking they're going to get the normal kind of indoctrination from me, you know, don't take me for a mug, it's going to be hard and it's going to be this. And they were looking forward to their cocktail party afterwards. And so when I actually threw two sets of car keys at them and said, right, business starts now, it caught them off guard a bit.
Business turned out to be two vanloads of wet fish.
That's a salmon, isn't it?
That must be a salmon.
First problem, identifying 600 quid's worth of slimy stock.
There's turkey on the side. Is that where it's from or what? It's yeah, obviously not fucking turkey, is it?
Who's just got the bloody squid? That costs money.
This is an absolute shambles.
Next pitfall, making a profit. And the boys blew it.
They've been wrongly priced anyway. £12.50 a kilo. We've been selling it all day long for £7.50.
First to find himself in hot water, trainee barrister Nicholas de Lacey Brown.
I'd rate myself at the current stage of my life as being outstanding in everything that I've done. In every single qualification, in every single course that I've done, I've always achieved the top grades.
Girls, a lovely place. Had it.
In charge of pricing the boys' fish, Nicholas got his sums wrong.
We're doing the lobsters $4.90 at the moment. Everything else will come out in a second. You want a lobster for $4.90?
The other fishmonger was selling lobsters per pound, but all that was shouted out was £4.90. And because he had set them at £4.90 per unit, that's what I put them down. I put them down as £4.90 each.
Everybody knows, anybody knows, that a lobster is not £4.90 for the lobster.
They've made a complete mix-up. I think it was due to somebody not understanding the difference between kilos and pounds. It was a big error. Obviously, it's easy to sell a lobster for £5 when it should be selling for 10 or 15.
Priced it wrong. You've got to take accountability for what your task was.
Yeah, no, I should maybe have gone through and looked at the prices properly, but remember how rushed we were. I'm doing all the pricing, all the marking up for every single thing.
Nick, just tell me what the lobster should be priced at, please.
Well, they should be 20. Well, I don't know. It's up to you.
I mean, after all, lobster's the type of food that a toff like him would be accustomed to. Maybe in the circles that he moves, perhaps he's never had to pay for it.
In Sir Alan's court, a cut-glass accent and special pleading failed to sway the judge.
I am very into art and culture and that kind of thing, and I find it very difficult to...
You don't want to get your hands dirty, that's the top and bottom of it.
That's rubbish. I find it very difficult to have conversations about football, for example, and these are the kind of guys that, you know, are really into that. And
what's that got to do with work? I mean,
no,
that's
kind of the division that I'm talking
So you feel there's a cultural divide here?
I'm an undereducated guy who's into football. That is how...
I mean, I don't mind who I employ. I don't care. It can be cockneys or toffs like yourself. But, you know, it's not really a reason why people can't work with each other.
These super intelligent academics like barristers, they are very, very good in their own field and they do live in their own little world. And when it comes to common sense or just a little bit of business acumen, they have none.
You weren't outstanding in this task. You were devastated when you got a B in your GCSE French. You're going to be even more devastated now because you got a big F. You're fired.
The case against me should have been thrown out of court as a submission of no case to answer. That is my legal opinion on the matter.
He may turn out to be one of the greatest barristers this country's ever had, but in the real hard business world, he's definitely deserved his big F, as I gave him.
Right, and this is the laundry. It's in mixed lots.
Yeah.
Week two. Sir Alan told the teams to start a laundry business.
The laundry task was kind of a favourite of mine, really. It's all about proving that you can start a business from scratch.
This is industrial laundry.
Yeah, well, that's not our laundry, after you there, is it?
This is your laundry.
This is our laundry,
yes.
There is a lot of stuff to do here.
The boys excelled. They got on with the job. There was a lot of labour involved in it, you know, and I think they did a very, very, very good job.
That's it, boys!
The girls were totally out of control. They didn't know what they were doing. Totally out of control under Jenny.
Hi, Jenny, it's Helene.
Earlier on today, I asked Lucinda to come back to me
regarding a tumble drying. She hasn't come back.
Let me make something very clear to you, Jen.
Now, you didn't specify anything.
And I, of course, will be as helpful as I possibly can.
Thank
Lucinda.
You. But please do not start pinning questions on me.
Which I was not asked to research.
Bickering led to catastrophic errors. First mistake, pitching £5,000 for a hotel laundry contract worth just £250.
Standard price for everything, £4.99 for every single item.
And is that your best price?
Yeah.
£5,000, right, for 1,000 pieces of linen. That's £5 a piece of linen, including a pillowcase, which you can buy 5 of them for £5.
Including in that price, we've got lots of things that we'd like to offer you. Mm-hmm. You've got a 24-hour hotline. Me and Jennifer will both be your personal account manager, so if you have any